Since Woot sent out a bunch of these SKYFi audio systems in their bag of crap, I thought I'd show you how to modify it to make it not completely useless. I've modified it so that this headphone out becomes a line in, and you can just plug in any 3.5 millimeter cord into there and play the audio through something other than the satellite receiver. The volume is useless, but it works pretty good with the volume on a normal device. What you need to start out with is the power adapter, since you probably didn't get one. I'm just using a 12 volt 1 amp. The stock one is 1.5 amp, but since you're not powering the satellite receiver, 1 amp's probably fine. You need to make sure you have a plug that fits on it too. I think those are pretty standardized. Make sure the adapter has the same signal or the same polarity as that symbol back there. And then you also need a cable. This is just a 3.5 millimeter jack on both ends to plug into there and to a phone. To start out with, you need to take these speaker covers off. They just pop off. Set those aside for now, and then unscrew all the screws that were in those speaker cover holes. Then this front panel should pop off like so. You can try to set it up there where you have a little room to work. This is the plug that comes out of that headphone jack there, and it has 5 pins on the bottom here. Here it is a little bit closer. If you can solder, the easiest way to do it is to just solder these 2 outer pins. Leave the center one as it is, but the 2 outer pins, just solder them together. If you don't have a soldering iron, what you could do it through messing with these wires here. What you'd want to do is cut them off, or cut the 2 outer ones off and leave enough room to work with on both sides. And you'd want to connect the outer one coming from this connector to the next one over on the wires going to the board. So it would be like this red one to this white one, and on the other side this black one to the yellow one. You don't need to worry about the other wires. You can just leave those unconnected. Okay, the next thing we need to do is remove the main circuit board over here so we can disable the standby mode for the amplifier. There's 2 screws right here, and then there's a nut with a screw on the other side of this battery cover that's holding on that antenna jack. Once you take all those out, the board will just slide out.
Okay, now that we have the board out, this chip right here is the one we're interested in. It has this little circle down in the left-hand corner that indicates pin number one. So we want to find where that is on the bottom side, which is right here. And that's pin number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What we want to do is connect pin number 4 temporarily to pin number 8. And we want to do this with just a small piece of wire. This is a twist tie with the ends stripped off. Anything else you might have will work. Try not to use a stranded wire because we want to connect only those two pins. And we want to do that with the power on. So we'll need to be careful here, but you want to plug the power in. And connect pin number 4, 2, 3, 4, to pin number 8. I guess it's not doing it because I already did this mod, but it usually sparks, and it is supposed to do that.
Then after doing that a few times, make sure you got a connection. You'll want to plug your audio back in and test it out. And that should be all we need to do for the mod.